Machiel Keestra, or Keestra, and I'm a visiting fellow at the Center for Philosophy of Science here at the University of Pittsburgh for fall of 2018. I'm a philosopher at the Institute for Interdisciplinary Studies at the University of Amsterdam, where I teach research in philosophy of science, in interdisciplinarity, and cognitive neuroscience. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about a project I'm involved in here at the center, which is a closer analysis of what actually happens when cognitive neuroscience integrates with another discipline, in the current case with theology. You may have heard of many neurodisciplines, including neuroethics, neuroeconomics, neuromarketing, neuroanthropology, etc., etc. And actually, this raises the question, what happens in these cases and what forms of interdisciplinary integration is taking place there? The study of interdisciplinary integration is actually taking place very recently only. It has been always a crucial feature of interdisciplinarity, but how to analyze this, how to describe it, has been somewhat of a mystery up so far. There have been several theories discussing interdisciplinary integration in terms of different forms. So when a field borrows a theory from another field or a method, or when perhaps different disciplines are involved in together solving a problem, a complex problem, like building the atomic bomb, which was one of the first main interdisciplinary projects, or doing medical policy studies. What these analyses often come up with is a somewhat prescriptive view of what integration should be. And by exploring here more the details of the history of a particular neurodiscipline, like neurotheology, I hope to be able to picture a more realistic sketch of the increasing integration between different fields. So what happened in the case of neurotheology? Well, theology, or the study of religion, or religion as a domain in itself, the terms are somewhat used interchangeably, this domain stretches out to very different questions and methods. It talks about hermeneutics of biblical text or other religious texts. It talks about institutional history of the church or other religious organizations. And also it talks about the psychology or personal experience of religion. Now what you see is that the approach of psychologists and neuroscientists alike to theology or the domain of religion consisted of a first step, namely to restrict the study to the domain of personal experience of religion. William James did as such in his lectures on the varieties of religious experience, for instance. Then the next step is to make this personal experience available for experimental study. For this, scientists have often used subjects with an extensive training in praying or meditation. For instance, in this slide that I've shown in my lunch talk, you can see the Dalai Lama looking at a subject to be put into a brain scanner and to see how his extensive practice of meditation has made an impact on the functions of his brain. So after limiting the domain to personal experience, it has also to be fit for experimental practices. Now, from these results, neurotheologists tend to generalize back again to religion as a whole. But my project will point out that these steps have to be taken into account, and also the limitations associated with them. Because what is happening is often a kind of an essentialization of religion, focusing on a particular form of religious practice, on a particular set of subjects, and also a kind of a commodification of religion, namely commodification of religion in terms of what it is to pray or to meditate. Nonetheless, I think that neuroscience and theology can benefit to each other, as religion presents a specific set of practices, stimuli, and a subject group with a highly trained subject, number of subjects, and vice versa. Cognitive neuroscience brings new techniques along for the comparative study of religion and the connection between different psychological functions, including religious ones. So the work here is really inspiring to do in this environment, and I'm looking forward to your responses or perhaps collaborations.